Hello, welcome back to Let's Play Gone Home. I'm the RPG Chick. Continuing off screen. Without saving, right. I found a few of those hidden things that we're supposed to look for, the panels and stuff. And, oh, we're supposed to be down here. I didn't open them yet. So I'm not going to show you guys that yet. Seriously, I just saw them and kept them, you know, I didn't open it. To keep the blind experience blind. it's here. 0451. Now, it's probably a combination for this, but we could also try it on Sam's locker. Right, I'm gonna write it down so I don't forget it. 0451. That was quite a jump scare there. Read document. Kubelik and Wise, attorneys at law, Boone County, Oregon. Dear Mr. Mason, please find enclosed your original document and a typed copy for your records. The notarized copy has been filed at our offices. Thank you for entrusting our firm with this important matter. Who's Mr. Mason? Sincerely, Jeffrey Wise, etc. Will and Testament. I, Oscar Mason, possessing full competence of mind and memory, and after full survey of valued items to my name, do hereby declare this document my last will and testament. The following shall hold true upon my passing. So why is this here? I declare, and who is he? I declare that I am a lifelong resident of Boone County, that I am unmarried and have no children. I declare that I have no outstanding debts to my name, to any creditors living or dead. Or do we inherit the house from him? Is that how that happened? I do hereby bequeath every item of value of which I may die possessed, including the dwelling and surrounding acres located at Arbor Hill. You are here, as well as any and all personal property and moneyed accounts to my nephew, Terrence L. Greenbrier, Jr. of Ellis County. In the event that said Terrence L. Greenbrier, Jr. should predecease me, then in such event the bequest to him shall fall and the same is bequeathed to his children as ordered by age and competence as stewards of the state. I subscribe my name to this will this 13th day of August 1973. Okay, this is the scrap copy. Right, same. Same, okay. So that's interesting, there's only that in there. So we found out where the house came from. Or who the house came from. Now, as far as this is this. Interesting. Second combo scrap. Property of Sam, private. 50-1. Half of Sam's locker cards combo added to backpack, okay. Read story. Also found another story. In a closet. See, I don't like that. I don't like that much either. Heaven at the edge of the world. Private, do not read. The Green Glacier Part 2. If something kills me, I will just look at this paper. And die while doing so. The Green Glacier Part 2. She was in 9th grade. December 1st, 92. Allegra and her scouting... I like these stories. Allegra and her scouting party peered down warily from the dense canopy of rustling leaves from their perch high in the forest branches. Mere feet away, sunlight shone brightly off the inner ice walls of the glacial basin. Thought I heard walking. Stop. I get way too creeped out by games like this. It's the immersion that kills me. Okay. Mere feet away, sunlight shone brightly off the inner ice walls of the glacial basin in which the forest grew. It was a strange sight indeed, such lushness juxtaposed with the frigid ice formations. Allegra leapt forward without hesitation, bounding through the high branches. The first mate had been captured by the Green Glacier's Amazonian tribe. His life hung in the balance. We have to hurry! Allegra's party followed behind, moving quietly as a breeze through the greenery. Allegra landed in the clearing and shouted, "Stop!" She saw the Queen Amazonian up on her pedestal, reaching for the lever that would drop her first mate into the vat below. She shouted, "No!" and flung her saber at the Amazon's reaching hand, but it was too late. The first mate screamed as he fell toward the water, then splashed down, and all was eerily silent. Allegra looked on, frozen in fear and remorse. She had been a moment too late. I thought the first mate was her friend, Lonnie, whatever. But then, from the vat, something began to emerge, a head of dark brown hair, just like the first mate's. Then the shoulders and sleeves of his coat, soaking wet. But as the figure stood and the water poured down, Allegra saw that the first mate had changed. He was no longer a man at all. In fact, what looked back at her with the eyes, the face, the hand and hands and body of a woman, still in the first mate's clothes, still the first mate. She spoke in a soft, clear voice. "Captain?" The Amazonian queen said, "She is one of us now. She is ours." Allegra drew her magical flintlock pistols from her belt, and her crew readied their swords. Allegra glared into the queen's eyes and said, "That's the love of my life, and you can't have her. Oh, I love it." I actually love that. Okay. So that's one passage. And there's another. I found it, too. I'm just not good at looking at maps upside down. Does that make any sense? I'm not facing the way of the map. What is that? Oh, that's a... Stop. You stop at that. There's one there, too. The Misfits. Special guest Maidenheads, did you?
At Todd's brother's place after the show, there was only a futon to sleep on, so Lonnie and I shared it. The lights went out. I was turned toward her. My eyes started to adjust, and then I could see she was looking at me, too. In the dark, she smiled. My heart was beating so fast. I rolled over. I felt so, I don't know, nervous? After a minute, she put her arm around me and was so close and whispered in my ear, "I really like you."
Aww.
I just nodded my head and I really hope she could tell. I really hope that she meant what I think she did. I felt like a shook-up can of soda ever since.
Jitters, Cola?
I hope we have the chance to talk before I explode.
That's adorable. I'm sorry. On the other side of Sam's room. We only have half the code. I could brute force it, but that would take... That would be exactly, 100 tries. Aha! That's the Ouija board. Hello, who are you, Oscar? What do you want to come, Second one is zero. Okay. So we had it. 051. Fascinating. Oh, look at that. Yeah. I'm not sure why I want to put everything back like that, just to not disturb the spirits, I guess. Okay. So 0, 5. Hopefully this gives us more clues on what to do. There's a key in here, because I don't know what else after this. Wait. Did I write it down wrong? Oh, 050. I put 0551. 051. Duh. Cigarettes. Oh, that's her? Oh, she's cute.
Lonnie came over today. Everything was different. She was sitting at my desk chair, and she wouldn't look at me. Finally, I asked her what was going on. She said she felt like she'd done something wrong that night in the city. Like I must think... But I said no. There was nothing wrong. I just wanted to say...
She stole those.
But I couldn't find the words. I felt like I was gonna cry, but I wasn't sad. She got up and sat next to me on the bed. I looked at her. Lonnie... Do you think you could ever... And that's when she kissed me.
Aww. Giggle. Hey, I love it. Did I see this before? Oh, I forgot to look at that other thing. Oh, Chun-Li moves. Lightning kick, 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 kick. That's cool. And I've looked at that. There was nothing wrong, and it's a backpack. Gosh, Sam. She's got a gentleman. Just like her father. Maybe she stole it from her father. Gillian Anderson, of course, because she's an X-Files fan. We know more about her sister than herself. I'm ignoring that. Sounds like footsteps. Exclusive interview with mogul David Geffen. In the Shenandoah. I don't like that. Gosh, Sam. So... The Morley cigarettes are from X-Files, I'm pretty sure. It's the pack that the cigarette-smoking man, a.k.a. Cancer Man, what do you call it? Smokes. I read that. Okay, so we've got a key. Tag says basement. Okay, good. To the basement is that way, okay. Like I really want to go in the basement. So we have some freaking thing to jump out of me. I'll just die, because I'll fling myself away from the freaking computer. That'll be okay, I'll die. We'll restart and then I'll probably take a week off from the game, like I did before. did that with the vanishing of Ethan Carter, when the zombie came up, and I was completely not expecting it because there were no jump scares in that game, actually before or after that. I forget where it was. It's here. Yeah. The Heaven at the Edge of the World. Samantha Greenbrier, grade 2. Story, The Turtle People, part 1. This is adorable. So yeah, I just looked at this first page. I didn't read it. She's been writing this forever. Captain Allegra looked off at the ocean. It went on forever. Well, so it seemed. Someday she would find the edge and get to the paradise there. Then she heard a cannon fire. Boom! It was the Black Pirate Ship. She yelled, I thought we lost them at Horse Island. The first mate said, looks like you thought too soon. The Black Ship came up along the side. Captain Black himself came out on the deck, of the Black Ship. He yelled to Captain Allegra, you're never gonna find the edge. There ain't no paradise, and your father were a liar. Captain Allegra yelled back, then why do you keep following us, you imbecile? The first mate yelled out, we'll stop you, Captain Black. We'll find the edge of the world, and you'll see her father was no liar. The battle kept going until Captain Allegra's ship got away. Now west, she said, and the ship sailed toward the sunset. That's cute. So, when she met Lonnie, the first mate, coincidentally, became a female, who she still loved. This is the basement? Yeah. Like, I really want to go in here. Let's see if there's anything past the door. I don't like this. Oh, I can see a little bit. There's no light anywhere? Oh. Read note. I'm facing this way and reading the note. Like it makes a difference. Sort of that way. Dear Samantha, I would like to cordially thank you for having me to your abode for the Thanksgiving holiday with your lovely family. I enjoyed the flavorful potatoes, and also it was weird being around your parents for that long. But it was pretty funny how impossible it is for your dad not to be awkward for more than 30 seconds at a time. Very cordially yours, your close friend and confidant, Lonnie D. A fancy man. Quite. Dear Mr. Soda, DeSoto, allow me to take the opportunity to thank you in kind for being such a gracious host of the festivities at your father's estate following the aforementioned meal with my parents. Your family's Thanksgiving feast was the more enjoyable of the two events, I must say. I especially appreciated the time I spent with your grandmother, who is a lovely woman with sterling taste and refined hair. Let's do it again. Same time next year, shall we? Indeed, Madam Samantha Greenbrier, Esquire. She wasn't really going to give that to her parents, right? Sorry. Chips. Oh, with a little baggy clip. Original Judy's, right? Judy's? Yep. Boulder, Colorado. Quiet down here. Sam and Lonnie. So we're like...
It's okay. Different now. I mean, we still hang out all the time like before. But now when no one else is around... Well, you know. So you could say we're dating. But it's secret. Secret dating?
I don't know. Secret love.
I mean, I guess that's the real difference. Now when we get off the phone or go home for the night, where it's just quiet and we're alone, we say I love you.
Why? Tell him a sucker for the whole story here. It's what's keeping me going, even though I'm, like, convinced something's gonna come after me. would jump out at me, even though I was told that wouldn't happen. It's really setting us up for it happening. Caitlin. Kind, amazing, intelligent, talented, lighthearted, important, and nice. Oh, it was like, what is that moving? I thought it was a cat. I was inside the frickin' thing. Oh man, what are my old sex ed assignments? I'm not gonna read all this. Oh, I read this already. So she didn't write a story. This is the same thing. I think. It's incredible how the female body knows how to prepare for pregnancy. Almost like what she wrote, but she wrote this big story. So, she got a better response. I don't know if it was the same teacher. I wasn't really paying attention. So I'm glad I found those passages, guys. I'm just terrible at reading maps when it's not facing the right way. Oh, the boiler room! Freddy's coming. Book. I cannot read that. Can I bring it in here where I can read it? A Course in Practical Pharmacy. 1943, wow. Is it like laundry room too? January 24th, 1985, Samantha Greenbrier. Dear Samantha, congratulations. I am pleased to inform you of your admission to the creative writing track of the Reed College Summer Program for Young Scholars for its 1995 session. We believe you have so much to contribute to the Reed College community. Based on your portfolio and academic record, I am pleased to offer you financial aid to cover 75% of the summer program's tuition and fees. The attached documentation delineates your schedule, optional secondary tracks choices, and your dormitory assignment. Please remember to submit the attached form if you wish to be eligible for one of the three Reed full-time undergraduate scholarships to be awarded to exemplary students at the end of each summer program. We very much look forward to your attendance. Again, congratulations on your admission and best wishes from all of us at Reed College. Sincerely, Julie Morris, Director of Admissions.
I'm so stupid sometimes.
Are you?
I was telling Lonnie that I got into my college summer program thing, and I was all making plans like, you should come visit me, stay in my dorm room.
Happen here.
But she said, Sam, I ship out on June 6th. I was like,
Richard.
Ship out? To where? She said, to basic training. What did you think I was doing all that ROTC stuff for?
What?
I guess she's been planning to join the army right after high school since she was, like, 12. And I guess she's really going to do it. So I was like, after graduation, I'm just never going to see you again? She said, let's just have fun while we can.
Huh? So this is why that pharmacy thing was over there, because there was a Richard Greenbrier, PhD, Professor Laureate of English, though. University of Oregon, 1956. And for some reason, his whole face was removed. That's weird, isn't it? Oh, this is one of Granddad's books. Gosh, delight. Joyce, A Complete Understanding. Oh, of Richard Greenbrier. That's his book. Joyce. Who's Joyce? So that's her grandfather's Richard, okay. Aw, LNS. A heart pendant. finding out a lot about our sister. In scary circumstances. One of Dad's books with something stuck to it. Oh. Let me read this in the light. I can't seem to get a good view here. Thank you for sending along a copy of your newly published book. An author's first published manuscript is a momentous occasion. I read it this afternoon. I certainly recognize my son in the subject matter. An author's work is the externalization of that which he holds dear and that which he fears. What's his father wrote it to him? Our grandfather. And in this respect, I believe your work was successful. But the lens through which the personal shone was needlessly clouded by genre cliches and implausible dime store science fictional de-es-machina. The great authors speak of their life's milieu in clear and honest tones, the lens crystal that refracts their thoughts without distortion. I congratulate you on surviving the great ordeal that is publication, and rest assured that readers of your chosen genre will lap up copies hungrily. But I urge you to shed artifice. You can do better. With the father's love and encouragement, Richard Greenbrier, M.D. You know? His father's really stern. Writing it like he's a, you know, his college professor or an editor or something. Binders on top of binders. I think that's Mom's citizenship stuff. Oh. Naturalization, where? Fair eyes, hazel. Wait. Oh. Complexion. Fair complexion. Yeah, fair eyes. Hazel eyes, brown hair. 5'6", born March 8th, 1950, married. Okay. Seattle, Washington. She came in on Seattle, Washington. In Seattle, Washington. In July 20th of 72. Where'd she come from? Oh, Canada. Stop the random thumping. You know, I hate that. It's immediately always followed by that sound. I don't like the looks of that. Two upstairs, huh? Girl Scout. The band formerly known as Cub Scout. Set list. Role model, authority, main squeeze, telling stories, instruction, first meet, self, Girl Scouts in denial.
Todd's band lost their singer. Todd said he sucked. Lonnie said he got sick of Todd's shit. And he was complaining about needing a new singer. So Lonnie was like, I can sing. And they were all kind of like, you can? And she was like, probably. But she's been rehearsing with them for like a week now, and I finally got to see them play in Todd's basement today. And she's actually really amazing. I feel so proud when she's on stage. It's incredible being in awe of someone you love.
Aww.
So everybody knows it's like a temporary situation till she ships out in June. But till then, I'm gonna be at every single show.
Is that a puzzle or just some random thing? Girl Scout. Self. She ordered it. She went ahead and ordered it. tattoo half of a heart pendant, custom engraving LNS. Wow. $80. Cash paid, wow. No note for that one. There's papers. We can't examine those like the others? Mm. Servants' quarters? There's a safe. Floor plan. This combination. Try the 0451. We'll try the... I did it right. 0501. Nothing on here, right? I don't like. Can't see. I can't close that. Order this month, 2 cases, or 1? I can't even tell. Anyways, brandy, rum, and whiskey. Governor remains very pleased with enforcement in Boone County. Believe this arrangement shall hold for some time. W.R. March of 23. I thought I saw something. Terry, age 6 in 1957. I don't like that. Guest room, Mr. Mason's room. Front door, library, kitchen. Oh, so you... The bell rings and they go help them? Yolanda de Soto, Estado Mexico, Miss Samantha Greenberg, blah, 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 roar. Dear Sam, today's Spanish lesson, X-Fly, Mosca, Sunbeam, Rea del Sol, Your Love, Tu Amor, Mudcap, Tapacubos. I'm so happy you liked the drawing. I was thinking of us when I drew it. I knew you'd be able to tell. You'd love Mexico, I think, probably. The nature here is totally different than back home. I keep thinking about Allegra and the first mate lost on a mysterious island where even the plants are out to get them. And then I think of them together, out there in the wilderness together, and I start thinking of you again. I lie here in bed and I can almost feel you. I've been trying to save it up for when we're together again. Seriously? I haven't done a good job, okay, but I tried. Okay, I think I know what she's talking about. Okay, enough about that. Your last letter got to me the day before we start driving back north. We'll be racing this letter home. If I get home first, we can read it together. And yes, I'm taking tons of photos. We'll have to spend so much time in the dark room. Heh, Lonnie. Looking for a 4-digit code. X-ray specs. $79.98. Is it her that used this? Just trying different things, guys. Was it written? $59.99 or $19.99? Firewood and cobwebs. Really don't like being in here. Could be in there. Could be mom's date of birth. Alright, well, we'll check this other room. What's with all the old magazines? I mean, newspapers. Is that a secret way in? Pretty. Hey, Sam, I'm writing you from Multnomah Falls. I'm here on a stupid class trip, which is stupid because it's March, and I don't know if anyone running the school has been to Oregon, but it's cold and rainy as shit in March. Wish you were here. Oh wait, you are here because I'm writing to you in the gift shop. Here you come.
They tell you to stick with the group on field trips, Katie. There's a reason for that. Lonnie and I snuck off on the side paths at Multnomah Falls and got a little lost.
Mason's Pharmacy.
Okay, a lot lost. Like, for hours. Right before the bus left, we found a trail and came running down the path, soaked and covered in mud, shouting for the bus not to leave. The school called home. Mom and Dad said, "You didn't get into trouble like this before you met that Lonnie girl."
Oh, come on.
But I don't think they know about us.
Doubt
it. Kids at school, though, I'm really afraid that's a whole other story. Stick with the group, Katie. Stick with the group.
Nah. Yeah, kids notice a lot of things you don't want them to. Is this a secret passage? Kinda looks like one. It's already on. I don't like this darkness stuff. It is a secret passage.